So here in the template for app component, I've added a heading and a paragraph. With this markup, we get something like this. This font you see here is Times New Roman. What if you want to change the font, or the font size, or the font weight? This is what typography is all about. So let me show you how you can work with the typography in Angular Material. First, on Angular Material website, let's go to the guides. And here, let's click Using Angular Materials Typography. So here in this list, you can see a bunch of CSS classes that we can apply to various elements. So we've got title, subheading, body, caption, and so on. Now, in order for these to work, first we need to import the Roboto font that is used by Angular Material. Of course, we don't have to use this font, we can use a different font, but this is the standard look and feel of Angular Material. So on this page, you can see the link to Roboto font on Google. So I'm going to simply copy this URL. Now let's go to styles.css. On the top, I'm going to import this font. Okay. Now back in app component.html, we can apply those CSS classes you saw earlier on these elements. So on the paragraph, I can apply mat-body-1. So all these classes are prefixed with mat dash. Let's have a look. So now here we're using the Roboto font. Similarly, we can apply a class to our heading to replace the Times New Roman with the Roboto font. So here I'm going to apply mat dash headline. And with this, this is our new heading. Once again, you can see the list of all the CSS classes on this page. So we use the headline class with h1. Now, applying all these classes to individual elements is very tedious. So a better way is to apply it at a global level. So let's go to index.html. In the last lecture, we applied mat app background class to our body element. We have a similar class called mat dash typography. With this class, we no longer have to apply individual classes to our headings, paragraphs, and other elements. So we can keep our code cleaner, and we still get the same result. Now, what if you want to customize this font, or the font size, or the font weight? That's the topic for the next lecture.